Hey guys, it's Becca. Welcome to my first update for my eyeshadow roulette series. This one is inspired by Sarah Rose. So if you're interested in seeing what colors I had last month and what colors I'll be using this next month, just keep on watching. So as I mentioned, this series is inspired by Sarah Rose. She did a whole eyeshadow roulette series for over a year, I believe, where she put all of her eyeshadows in a random number generator, or at least listed them out and then used a number generator to pick which ones to use. I did it a little bit differently. I have all of my eyeshadow palettes listed in order, and I just use a random number generator to pick first the palette, and then once I have the palette chosen, I pick use the random number generator again, with the limits being the number of shadows in that palette, and then I pick another shade that way. And I did that with 4 palettes for eyeshadows and 1 face palette. And I added the face palettes in just because I have a ton of them. I mostly got them from subscription boxes and I haven't really used them as much as I should have, so I'm kind of rolling them in. It's kind of a fun way to play with them and have an exciting new, like, ooh, which one am I gonna get? As for the eyeshadows themselves, when I first started this, I didn't really have any kind of particular goals except for maybe to use the eyeshadows as much as I could, but I still felt like it was pretty unstructured and I was kind of struggling a little bit to try to figure out how to make this fun. Otherwise, I felt like I was just doing, like, dipping into like 4 different palettes to get 1 look and just picking random colors from them, and that wasn't really that fun to me. So what I came up with, and I just came up with it last week so I don't have a whole ton of looks to show you, but I would have a goal of matching each palette with each of the other palettes and using the chosen shade as well as 1 other shade from each of those palettes to make a look. So for example, I would use the CColor palette and this Makeup Revolution palette. I'd use the colors that I picked from the random number generator plus 1 more color from each palette to make my look. And I would do that with each combination of palettes that I have. So that does make 6 looks. So we'll just go one by one, kind of doing a recap of the shades that I have. The first one I have here is very reflective and shiny. This is the Milani Pure Passion eyeshadow palette. And this one is a very kind of mauvey pink eyeshadow palette. Very beautiful. I love it. And the color that I had chosen was this one. So you can see there's quite a dip in there. I do like this one as a lid shade. But I do find that I had to really build this one up. It wasn't as shiny and reflective as I was hoping it would be, but I do still really like it. So there it is. It's very pretty and reflective and it has some good dimension to it, but I don't know why I was hoping it would be even more reflective. I think I was expecting a duochrome, honestly. Next color that I have is from the CColor palette from Around the World. This is a dupe of the Urban Decay Born to Run palette. I believe that is on sale right now, so if you're interested in getting it, now will be the time. But there it is. This is the color story here. It's beautiful. It's gorgeous. The shade that I was working on was this brown shimmer shade, and as you can see, it's looking pretty disrupted now. I hadn't used it very much at all before putting it into this project, so I'll just go ahead and give that one a swatch so you can see that one next to the Milani shade. And it's just very pretty, but it surprised me, and it has kind of a little bit of a peach shift to it, which I wasn't expecting. Third eyeshadow palette is one that I also had in my pan those eyeshadows for the last month. I did pan one of the eyeshadows, so as you can see, I hit the pan in the shade Dusk, but the other shade that I have in my eyeshadow roulette was this one here, Sheen. I did not hit the pan, but I was expecting it any day. I was getting pretty close, but it's pretty, but this one isn't as shiny and reflective as I wanted it to be. It's just, like it says, a nice little sheen. So there, you can see that. You can barely see it. It's like a subtle highlight. Sorry about that. I just realized how shiny I was and I tried to powder that down a little bit. It's very hot here in North Carolina. I'm not really sure if I did any difference, but we're gonna go with it. Last eyeshadow palette that we have in this eyeshadow roulette for last month was from the Makeup Revolution Optimum palette. It's actually a very gorgeous fall palette that definitely did not get enough attention in my collection before. And of course, the shade that I had was again a champagne kind of shimmery color. I had this one here, Peak, I believe is the color that it's called, but there's a lot of other really beautiful colors in this palette, so I was happy to have it out and playing with it. Let me go ahead and give a swatch of that one. I think I'm about to drop all the things in my lap. There we go. So you can see it right next to the studio makeup one. It's a little bit brighter than that one and a little bit less gold. The last item for last month is this here, the CColor Contour Palette. And the color that I chose, you can see they're all listed on the back as well, was this one, shade 4. It was this light contour shade. And as you can see, I've done some pretty good use on this one. I used it almost every day as kind of a very gentle contour, a little bit right here and a little bit on the sides of my nose. I'm working on it. This is a judgment-free zone, of course. But this had been untouched before that, and I'm expecting I might hit pan at some point. You can see the pan through the product now, so I'm pretty excited about that, especially considering this was completely untouched before this project. So before we choose the new colors for next month, I'm gonna go ahead and show you the looks that I created pairing each pair of palettes together. I'm going to show first the palettes that I paired together, then swatches of the colors that I used, and then just a close-up of the look, and then we're gonna go ahead and get on into the new colors. Last look is the one that I'm wearing today. That is the combination of the CColor palette and the Studio Makeup palette. So now the most exciting part of this is when I get to pick the new eyeshadows. For the first eyeshadow that I chose, it was from the CColor Golden palette. I was really excited to get this one in the mix because I love this palette. You can tell it's been well loved by me and well used. The color that was chosen for me is this dark brown matte shade. I'll go ahead and swatch that. We have last month's color story here. I will swatch this month's color story on the other hand. There we go. So you can see there it is. Second palette, and I promise I didn't rig this, but I'm so excited that the second palette that was chosen for me is this one, the Artemis. This is the newest palette in my collection. It is a dupe of the Metropolis palette. So this is another Natasha Denona dupe in the same thing here. But isn't that gorgeous? The shade that was chosen for me, though, is another brown. So I guess I will be playing with a lot of brown this month. So there you can see the swatch of that one right underneath the CColor swatch, and that is beautiful. It has more of a like a mustardy undertone that I wasn't really expecting, so that'll be fun. Third palette chosen for me is this one here, the Storybook Cosmetics Little Briar Rose. Gigantic thing here. The only place I can store them is like out here to make it pretty. But the color that was chosen for me is Spindle. So this one is a little bit outside of the color story that I have so far, just some browns that are warm. Now I have this kind of a corally pink something or other. There we go. So that's three mattes already. There we go. Look at that, that's so pretty. One more eyeshadow palette and a face palette left to be able to choose for this. So the next one is this Emeralds palette by Profusion is my last palette. So here are all the colors in this one. This one is one of my current favorite palettes. I absolutely love all these greens. I love the colors that they paired with them. Of course, in a green palette, I was hoping to get a green chosen, but the color that was chosen for me is, let me check my notes, Burst is this bold golden color. So I'll go ahead and swatch that one as well. So there we go. That's what I've got so far. I've got three mattes and one shimmer. And all that is left for me is the face palette. And so my random number generator chose for me this Flower Beauty Holographic, what is it, Shimmer and Strobe Highlighting Palette, the lighter shade. So the shade that was chosen for me is the middle one, that pinky highlighter. So as you can see, I've gotten some use in this, but there's definitely a ton of product left, and the shade that was chosen for me is this one, which is nice because I don't really have many highlighters on my vanity right now. I have one, which is in my project 10 uses, and I'm about to roll it out pretty soon. So there we go, there's that one. It's a very subtle, very nice pinky kind of color, and I'm sure I can use that as like an inner corner or brow bone highlight when it comes to eyeshadows as well. So there you have it. This was last month's color story for my eyeshadow roulette, and I'm really excited about my new kind of goals, is trying to pair all the eyeshadows and use them that way. I found I was a much more exciting about trying to pair up the colors and seeing what else I could use in the palettes. So I'm excited to go forward using this as kind of my base color story, but I have all the eyeshadows in the palettes outside of these colors available as well. So super excited. Wish me luck, and I hope I see you all in the next one. Bye.